make my mama stop working, that's the promise. Going big, going big. Everybody go, they know the click. Way too many wins, they notice it. They was hating, know they sick. Acting like they know me, cause I'm going big, going big. Everywhere I go, they know the click. Way too many wins, they notice it. They was hating, know they sick. Acting like they know me, cause I'm
P-P-P-Lo, time to bring the bass bird.
Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? Are you ready?
Get ready, dog.
Okay, Coach, thank you. EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is in Uptown Charlotte, North Carolina at Bank of America Stadium. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the New Orleans Saints and the Carolina Panthers. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. First time with Alvin Kamara. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard. Now a first carry for Latavius Murray. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Let's go now. 18 Gator. 54.
Rip right.
Jones on first down gets this to a standout receiver, Thomas, and he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. That throw good for 4. It's second down
at the 44-yard line.
Ready, 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and 6. Throwing, Jones. Wide open receiver complete. Touchdown, New Orleans. A big play there. His first touchdown of the new season. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive. With these Thursday night games, sometimes you get those quick turnarounds. You wonder how a team is going to start. They started really well.
Everyone's always wondering, going into a Thursday night game, who has their legs, who has a, you know, the overall health of a team. But mentally, if you get that early edge, the other team might think to itself, ah, it's been a short week. We're not really ready to go. You might run them into the ground that way. That's why getting that early score means a lot.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And an excellent return there as he's up to the 35, but make it the 40-yard line.
Well, you gave up the first touchdown of the game, but how about the response? Big-time return. Now it's their chance to try and put points on the board.
Good starting position for the Panthers as they come up first and 10 at the 40. First carry for Christian McCaffrey. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Greer will look to throw on second down. And the Saints pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. The sack coming from defensive end Cameron Jordan.
I spent a lot of extra time preparing for this game watching this offensive line because they gave up 5 sacks last week in their loss. They just gave up another one now. They don't seem to be working together as a cohesive unit. Right? 4 guys might have it right, but the 5th guy is giving something up. They've got to find a way to all get on the same page.
Taking a shot for Samuel. Incomplete. Both players were there offensively and defensively, but it falls incomplete.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
We got this.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. They'll be looking to duplicate that first drive, the one that got them that 7-0 lead.
Of course they would. I mean, look, they're on the road. So getting the 7-0 lead was huge for them, right? Imagine getting up 2 touchdowns on the road, taking the crowd out of the game. It'd be ideal.
They begin on the ground with Kamara. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1-yard gain up to the 15.
Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stop that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
Let's go, D.
On second and 9, Jones looking left sideline, incomplete. That was Dante Jackson, the one who got a hand in to knock it away. With that matchup, the adjustment that was made, you have a blazing guy on a blazing guy, and defensively, he won that battle.
The closing speed is the key. When you have a guy that fast and he can close at the end of a play and knock it away, that's a big deal, and we just saw him do it right there.
Now Jones. Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara. 12 yards there, good for a Saints first down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Get in the weight room.
On first down, Murray. And some room to run now. And he's brought down after a very nice gain. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first. We often poke a little fun at running backs past the age of 30. Oh, they're getting old. They can't run anymore. Well, he's showing past the age of 30, you can still have some nice runs like that.
You certainly can. And I think that we're starting to expand our definition of old running back. Because it used to be as soon as they hit 30, we wanted to get rid of these guys and go to the younger guys. But now that the guys are taking such great care of themselves, as you pointed out.
A breakaway for Michael Thomas. Touchdown, New Orleans. Michael Thomas, his second touchdown on the season. And the Saints able to stretch that lead out further. Good start to the season for him. He had the touchdown last week in the opener and a second one in week two now.
How about the pace he's already established, right? Not sure he can keep it up for an entire season, but don't burst the bubble because he thinks that he can.
Do guys go into a season with a goal for touchdown scored or yardage? What do you think?
I think every single one of the guys who's going to touch the football, they all have those types of goals. They all have those types of thoughts. Then they just have to see how the season unfolds if they can stay with it.
Unfolding so far so good for him. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays.
You ready?
Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything, at least 3 points, get that zero off the board. 14 yards, good for a Panther first down. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Greer on first down. And he whips that one incomplete there. The intended receiver there, Ian Thomas, and it's second down. He shook his head right when he released that throw. He knew it was going to be a little off target.
Yeah, the excitement got him on that one. Wasn't able to control the fact the receiver was open, and it would have been an easy throw.
On second down, McCaffrey. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Set, ready? 50, plant. Recon, 132 fighter.
They fake the handoff, now Greer. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 45. And his guys will take over at their own 44-yard line. Unfortunately for him, if last week was any indication, we knew a pick was coming at some point. Last week it was interception after interception, and here we go again.
We actually quit counting last week at a certain point because I thought I was going to run out of fingers, right? Because I'm not all that skilled as a mathematician. But you're right. It felt like a matter of time, and you got to think the guys on defense, they couldn't wait for this opportunity after what they saw on tape.
8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. They keep it on the ground, but this time it's Murray. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. The second down play results in a loss of 2 yards.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
From the midfield stripe, they look to throw. Oh, he's able to outmuscle him here as he pulls it in. Give him 30 yards there. How about this first quarter for them throwing the football?
This defense has zero answers for what they've seen so far with the ball in the air. I'm not sure how they're going to change things around, but offensively, I keep attacking. I keep throwing the football until they make me change.
They're going to be stopped up on this first down run. He might have gotten back to the line of scrimmage, but that's it. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10.
Go, 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 go.
Ready? Here's the first carry for Bo Scarborough. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. 5 yards on the carry there, and it leaves him with third and about 6 yards to go.
5 yard pickup on the play. And it's third down.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. The Panthers turn to their nickel set here as they get ready for third down. Now Jones from the gun, he'll throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Chris Jones able to record his 5th sack of the season. And keep your eye on that man. 4 sacks last week, 1 there here in the second quarter. He can be so disruptive.
So what was he doing in the first quarter? What was going on?
Took a nap.
I think he tried to lull him to sleep a little bit. Like, yeah, okay, maybe you've got me this week. No longer. And you know, with the 4 sacks last week, it's obvious he gets his in flurries.
And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And we don't want to call this desperation time, especially in the second quarter, but you're down.
You don't want to.
No, but well, let me finish.
Okay, my bad.
You're down 3 scores already. You've done nothing offensively, nothing on the scoreboard. That's not a good combination.
I think you just called it desperation time.
I think you did.
But let's face it, you mentioned this to me in a break earlier in the game. The energy level hasn't been there right from the start. We've noticed that. They've got to find a way to get on their toes and start punching instead of retreating, to use a boxing analogy.
He's going to fire one deep over the middle into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. He's picked off just shy of midfield, and they'll set up shop in enemy territory at the 45-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
On first and 10, Jones firing quickly here, and that's complete.
And, partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal, because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up 2nd and 6. On the ground, this is Kamara. They'll wind up getting 4 down to the 36. I think you mentioned in the opening drive that these guys needed to establish the run, protect the young QB. I actually wrote that down, believe it or not. So how would you assess things so far?
I'm kind of touched that you actually wrote something like that down. I appreciate that, partner. But I do think they've been able to do that, maybe not as effectively as they've wanted to. But I think we'll see more of as this game goes along, because they want to continue to take care of that young QB.
This is Scarborough. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain that time, and they're going to be left looking up at a 4th and 1. And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle. And the lead now increases to 20 to nothing. They got the interception, but very little movement after, and that forces him to settle for 3. And it does feel like settling when that happens, doesn't it?
It certainly does, but we got to give a lot of credit where it's due, and that's to the defense, because they ran onto the field. It's what we call sudden change, right? Interception, you got to go put out the fire, and they did, holding them to a field goal.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. 13 yards, first down, Panthers. From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10.
First and 10 at the 32-yard.
McCaffrey. And he'll scratch out only about a yard up to the 32.
That didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
On 2nd and 9, Greer. That's to McCaffrey, complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Give him 15 there, and the Panthers have a first down. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. First down, Greer. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Cameron Jordan, his second sack of the night.
And that's the first sack of this game, but how about last week? Six sacks. Great coverage downfield, which helped that pass rush. They are really working in sync right now.
To try again after the sack. Greer, Alex Anzalone. He's the one that drops him this go-around, and that pass rush getting strong here. Back-to-back sacks. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Greer. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Marcus Davenport. The offensive line is in tatters as that's now three sacks in three plays. Pilardi now on to punt as he sends this one away. 51 yards on the punt there. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. On first down, Jones. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Gerald McCoy just would not be denied. That's a loss of seven.
Well, maybe that can give him a little bit of a pick-me-up, a little bit of a jolt. One of the few things has gone right defensively.
Because other than that, it's really been a first half to forget. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Looking to throw, Jones. That's to his running back. It's Alvin Kamara. 1:57 to go in this first half on EA Sports. Reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend. On third down, here's Kamara. He's got a first down and then some inside the 40 and down right around the 37. 14 yards is the pickup. First down, New Orleans.
Just about every coach we talk to says the crowd shouldn't affect us. That shouldn't be an issue. And then the next breath, they talk about taking the crowd and taking them out of the game by picking up first downs and keeping them at bay. I think we just saw an example of that there, didn't we?
It's important to do, especially early in the game like they have. But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
It's a lot of contact going on there. And in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. Line of scrimmage, again the 37 as they line up second and 10. From the gun, it's a run for Kamara. And he's going to be hemmed in and brought down right at the line of scrimmage. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down.
On the set.
Right there. 54 Mike. I'm going to come back to you.
Check 37. Check 37.
Slam.
Here's Jones operating from the gun. Looking right sideline, that's complete. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. The previous play, they barely got back to the line of scrimmage. Now they pick up over 30 yards. A chance to really cap off a big first half here as they come up on first and goal.
Six guys.
Back to throw. Jones. under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Ha-ha, Clinton Dix making the safety blitz look easy. Zooms in for the sack.
Well, that was point counterpoint, wasn't it? They decide to throw for it on first and goal. Instead, the defense counters with pressure, and the defense wins, getting a big sack.
So they get pushed back to the 11, and here's second and goal. Murray. And he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal? Looking to throw. Jones. That is caught. Traquan Smith. Touchdown, Saints. Traquan Smith. His first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Saints able to stretch that lead out further. Lutz good on the extra point. And the rout is on here in this first half. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And he'll probably wish he'd reconsidered here. It will cost him 10 yards as he's down at the 15.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these team special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive.
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off near the 44. At a potential turning point as they'll get the football in very good field position late in this first half. At the 42-yard line.
Ready to break.
Mike's by four. I got wide. Alert three.
Topper. Snap.
Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Second and six. And that will be incomplete. Four ticks left here on the clock. He was trying to get it to his running back, Alvin Kamara. And it's third down. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. This officially a 55-yard attempt. And he has got it from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt. So we've come to halftime after a very one-sided beginning to this one. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, set now to go for the third quarter. The Saints have the lead and set to receive the kick. And he'll probably wish he'd reconsidered here. It will cost him 10 yards as he's down at the 15.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
Let's go now.
The Panthers 70, out there and ready 80. To begin their next drive. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
Yeah, they're down big right now. So as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained. Maybe calm their whole team down and find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down big, you're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts them.
Ready. 50, plant.
15, check by 15. You better bring it. I'm letting you know right now, you better bring it. 25, check 25.
Get it. On the ground, McCaffrey. slipped one tackle, but no more as he's knocked to the deck behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it will go as a one-yard loss, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Let's get it.
Set. 90, Wolf.
I got double tight. Double tight.
Hey, seam six. Seam six. Leo.
Greer on third down. He sets to fire deep. And almost intercepted. That would have been his third pick in this game alone. Instead, fourth down. Another drive comes and goes. Still nothing on the scoreboard.
Yeah, and when the second half comes, you know, it's real easy to get discouraged and wonder if you're ever going to get things started. You just got to fight through it. Got to keep pounding away.
A big boot that time, 57 yards the official distance. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away. Defense, we got the lead. Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see if the offense gets done.
On second down now, it's Baldwin. They follow up the gain of two with a gain of one that time.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Oh, yeah, I'm coming.
Jones now to throw on third down. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Dante Jackson picks it, and his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. They brought the house that time on the young rookie, maybe a little rattled through the pick.
And you have to be prepared for a lot of pressure as a rookie quarterback, because most defensive coordinators are going to test you that way. So when you see that, the ball's got to get out of your hands quickly, and that means your receivers have to understand they have to break off their routes quickly as well.
They're going to get about three here out of this first down run, and that'll bring up second and 7. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
Greer just beating the play clock. This one complete to Curtis Samuel. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. Give him 25 yards on the play there. And now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. And now they're going to get him down right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down. Defensively, though, they had a chance there to hit him for a loss. Couldn't get it done.
Looked like someone was able to knife into the backfield, but he wasn't able to get him down. But his compatriots, they were able to grab him at the line of scrimmage and not let him get any further downfield.
The first carry for Josh Adams. And he'll get about four there as he takes it from the 10 down to the 6.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
On the ready. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game.
Mike's 50.
They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
They went with the dive look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
And the 12-year veteran knocks it right through, and they'll make a small dent in that big deficit as it's down to 27. I'm kind of surprised by that they kicked the field goal. I guess you get some points, but this deficit third quarter, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't either. Yeah, I'm with you on that one. When you're down that much, kicking a field goal, does it feel a little bit maybe waving the white flag and just want to get out of here? Yeah, I think you got to go ahead and try and get some bigger points on the board.
Ready, set.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now they'll run it with Scarborough. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. The last run got 9. That leaves them with 2nd and a yard.
Here we go, D.
Kamara trying the right side. And some space here. There he goes. Touchdown, New Orleans. Alvin Kamara, his first touchdown of the new season as his guys continue to put this one out of reach. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points?
The kicker.
Exactly.
And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. Christian McCaffrey. His first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Panthers are able to cut into this lead. Extra point try good by Gano. And the lead drops from 34 down to 27. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
Let's go.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments. Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5.
54, 61, match box, let's go.
2nd and 5. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
When an offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because they should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback, a hot route, so to speak.
And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And it'll be 2nd and 12.
Ready.
The 34-yard line.
Mark 54. I got one.
Ready.
Jones from the gun, he'll throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Brian Burns. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him. And now they're looking for 19 yards here on 3rd down following 2 negative plays.
Switch.
Hey, Sam off. Defender.
Now Jones operating from the gun. And the throw there going to be incomplete. Here's Thomas Morstead now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. He They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. And that'll kick and go out of bounds just outside the 15 at the 16-yard line. And we're back now in Charlotte. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number four. Greer and the Panthers set to go first and 10 at their own 16. A throw left side to start the drive is complete. A good pick up there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Facing a second and 2 after that last catch. Good for 8 yards. A play fake. Now Greer to throw. Taking a shot for Samuel. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by Eli Apple. And he'll score. Touchdown, New Orleans. Defensively, they've had their way in this one. That pick six makes that scoreboard even more lopsided.
I remember talking with a guy in the league, and I said, what do you do when the game's like this? You know, it's pretty much over. You ready to go to the bench and hang out? And he said, oh, heck no. I want to stay on the field. I might get some stats. I might get a pick or two.
You like being out there at the end of these wide margins.
When they have to throw it, that gives you more opportunities to go get it.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Fresh off the six the other way, it's Greer. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Marcus Davenport able to drop him that time for his second sack of the evening. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Here's Greer. That he can't hang on. He had a good shot there for his third pick of the game. Instead, it's third down. Just nothing there again. He's been sacked multiple times. We've seen the interceptions, of course. He's really been through the ringer, hasn't he?
And what we've seen is a defense is well
in trouble, and the ball's out. It's in. It's loose. The ball bouncing around, and it's going to go out of the back of the end zone, so that is going to be a safety. Things are just going from bad to worse now. It's a safety that does him in here, and that is one frustrated offensive unit.
They can't get out from under their own shadow right now. I mean, I know this is the NFL, but could you imagine a college crowd right now? Imagine what they'd be doing. They'd be chanting, start the bus, because they think this one is over.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup? Let him get some time.
And that's one of the great questions in the NFL, Brandon, because I'm just going to tell you, in the 2015 season, I commentated on 3 games in a row that were blowouts. And in none of them did the starting quarterback ever come out of the game for the team that had a big lead. And in each instance, I asked the coaches later on, why didn't you do that? And they all looked at me and said, just don't really do that in the NFL. We, you know, these guys play, and we just play them all the way through. Now, in certain situations, they will take them out, but for the most part, they're not as worried and concerned about getting them out of the game. And that's always puzzled me a little bit.
Following the delay, here's second and 9. They'll run it now out of the gun. They'll have a first down past the 40. And he'll get this all the way up to the 42-yard line. 12 yards there, good for a Saints first down. Another example of this offense really having their way, Charles, and another big chunk play there on the ground.
And when you look at the defense, they've got to do a much better job of wrapping up when they tackle. A lot of great opportunities continue to slip through their fingers, as do the runners.
Right back to him on first down. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring up a second and 11.
Hey, rock it.
Here's Murray. They get 9 yards back on the run there, and they're left with a much more makeable third and two.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
The Saints on third down, 5 out of 9 thus far. Here it's third and two. Now Scarborough. And he has the first down yardage before they bring him down right at the 45. Able to get what they need to keep the drive going with a 6-yard pickup on third down. So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. They run on first down as they get about 3. Second and 7 forthcoming. Ha-ha, Clinton Dix there for the stop.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old-school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense? What's that, 5 straight runs?
Yeah, 5 straight carries to start this drive, and like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. Now a first carry for their fullback. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about 4 to go.
And that was a good collision right there. And I know this as a former defender. If you're playing linebacker, you're going through a checklist on every play on who you think's going to get the ball, where you think the ball's going to go. Rarely do you expect the fullback position to get it. And on that play, he did. So you've got to steel yourself at that point because the contact is going to be strong.
And he's taken down inside the 30. 10 yards, good for a Saints first down.
Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on third down, and we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball, you often feel like you're just a step behind whatever they're doing offensively.
And one of the differences in this game, no doubt. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals. Looking like they're well on their way to a 2-0 start. All smiles right now on that sideline, isn't it?
As well there should be. It's hard to win a game in the NFL. We hear it all the time. We know that it's difficult. But guess who's smiling, but inside is thinking 24-hour rule because we're going to have to play again next week.
Boss man.
Oh, without a doubt. The head coach, he wants them to feel good, but at the same time, find a way to keep improving.
This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And last time they surrendered the safety, we know they don't want to do that again.
That is just one of those oddities in scoring that we get, and it's just so strange to see that go up on the board.
And now here is another interception, picked off by Marshawn Lattimore. Wait a second, they declined the penalty?
I'm as puzzled as you are, partner. I don't understand how any time you lose possession of the ball, yet you turn down a penalty that would give you possession back. Let's make this simple. Anyone who plays the game, take the football. Always take the football.
Penny break.
Check Mike 54. Mike 54.
Let's get the ball.
And they'll indeed take a knee.
Ball is on the keeper. It's a loss of a yard. Brings up second and 11 at the 24-yard line.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they look to salt this one away.
Ready, ready. Ten over.
Check, check. Three down.
Hit it.
And they take a knee. So they lost yardage and they declined the penalty. There's no logical reasoning to do that.
I'm trying to go through this little Rolodex in this small brain of mine, and I'm coming up with nothing, partner. I've got zip on that one. Take the yardage, right? Take the penalty. I don't get it.
I don't get it either. He gets this away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds.
First and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
Oh.
On the ready.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in the game like this, and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And the coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build
on. Just something to build on. Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
Ready, so set. Now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. A big offensive explosion help leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Saints, it was a great all-around performance as they come out of this one with the victory. And they'll get a few extra days to get ready for next week. Meanwhile, for the Panthers, they'll drop to 0-2. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports, I'm Brandon Gauden, saying so long, everybody.